The recount has confirmed the original results of the Progressive Party gubernatorial primary. Seems they got it right the first time. Good evening, I'm George Mallet.
And I'm Stephanie Gorin. It appears the recount in Vermont's Progressive Party for governor will not change the outcome. But the 2 days spent last week recounting 1,000 ballots did expose some irregularities and one big error that the judge wants to hear before certifying final results tomorrow.
New at 6, News Channel 5, Stuart Ledbetter fills us in on the political developments breaking late this afternoon, and he's in the newsroom tonight, Stu.
Hey, George. Well, at a hearing in Montpelier, the judge said the recount has, in fact, widened what had been a one-vote gap. Now 41 votes separate these two candidates. There are only a half a dozen disputed ballots statewide left for him to resolve tomorrow, so you can say this is over. He will declare Martha Abbott the winner of the Progressive primary for governor, a nomination she's already declined, thereby dashing hopes for write-in candidate Annette Smith to try to pull off an upset. But we can say there were also some confusing instructions given volunteers in this recount, some sloppiness as well, including a mistake by the Secretary of State's office initially awarding dozens of votes to Smith that she actually hadn't received. Here's how it happened.
It was a very regrettable human error made about 9:30 on Saturday night with a staff that had already worked over 75 hours that week. And when someone went to hit the 5, they hit the 5 and the 8 numbers together, and it printed out 58.
Do we need to make changes in the process for recounts in your judgment?
Yes, we do. We also need to make changes in the timing of the primary.
And the judge seemed to agree, saying there's just not enough time between Vermont's primary and general election deadlines to do a careful job. A June primary, anyone? By the way, Annette Smith, an outspoken leader of a group opposing big wind projects, will continue on as a write-in candidate in November, we're told, but she won't have the traction of being a major party nominee. George?